Margot, it's a pleasure to welcome you here into my home.
I thank you very much.
It's truly an honor, and I'm delighted and excited to talk about your new recording project. This is of particular interest to me because you're not just starting out your career, but this is in fact your first commercial recording. What does that feel like, and how did you choose the three last Beethoven sonatas?
First of all, it was a dream of mine to play this program. The three sonatas form a perfect triptych. You know, a triptych is a work of art with a centerpiece and two adjoining works in the visual field. But this is a musical triptych of absolute perfection. I became acquainted with Opus 110 when I began to study seriously at the age of 13, 14. So I've really known this music since I was in my early years. And then I attended a concert by Claudio Rao in San Juan, in which he played Opus 111 and Opus 109. And that was a revelation. I was about 4 feet away from him because my teacher had availed me of stage seats. And I said to myself, this man is being transformed by this performance, by his own playing, and by the music. And I said to myself at that point, I want to do this someday.
I can only imagine how this music and the process of learning it, performing it, and recording it changed you.
Oh my goodness, in so many ways. It was a transformative experience for me, and one that will stay in my memory forever.
I'm also wondering what you've learned about Beethoven in the process of going through this journey.
That he was a very good man. That he had goodwill towards humanity. He was not shy about knowing who he was and what he could accomplish as a composer. He knew he was going to continue to live through his music forever. And I think that's a little bit one of the things that we as artists all want to do. We want to leave something behind. So he set himself out to outdo himself. He began to write the first sonata of the triptych, Opus 109, and he felt deathly ill. Then he overcame that, and so came Opus 110, and eventually the last one, Opus 111. It represents essentially the culmination of a career in the writing of the piano sonata as a form of composition as we know it. But it is at the same time so much more than that. It is essentially and simply a perfect example of the triumph of the human spirit over adversity. Opus 111, you can hear, you know, it begins dramatically in a minor key, and the first movement ends in a major key, which is the first sign of hope for the future. And then comes the wonderful arietta with variations in the second movement. And it's all about hope and transformation and transcendence. And it ends in a beautiful C major chord. So he ended his contribution to the sonata form with the view of a happy future. And that means a lot to me, that I can convey that hope and a vision to the future to others through my playing and through my recording.